Bye-bye.
Take care. I see him every day.
Hi.
Are you guys vlogging?
Yes, we're vlogging.
That's awesome.
We show.
My girlfriend do that all the time.
You do? Yeah. No. Oh my god.
Hey.
Alexis guy.
Alexis, thanks for here.
It's awesome though.
Yeah, it's a fitness vlog. How deep is your love? Is it like the ocean? What devotion are you? How deep is your love? Hey guys, so today I'm going to be shooting you guys something that's been kind of actually requested a lot lately. And it is tips on how to get started on fitness. So I wrote them down on my journal, which I got at Walmart, and it says, let your dreams set sail. I'm sorry, I haven't done my nails. Anyways, it's super cute and I love it. Yeah, so we're gonna talk about the 10 tips on how to get started if you're a beginner. So just a couple of things before we get started. I want you guys to know that, one, I'm not a professional. These are things that have worked for me, things that I think has worked for a lot of people in general. So these are not like the specific 10 tips you must do to get started. I'm sure maybe I forgot like a couple of big ones. These are just things that I've noticed that really helped me get started. Number one is your mental approach to how you get started. So when you get started, a lot of people, I think, they get started with the mentality of, well, I want to be fitter, or I want to lose weight, or there's like a certain amount of weight that you want to lose because you want to be thinner. And everyone just has that. You want to look better, you want to feel better, you want to be confident, and that's completely normal. I think a lot of people also, they try and then they fail. And that is because of the mentality that they take on it. So when you start, most people are prone to start working out when it gets closer to summer. Why? Because bikini season is right around the corner. And so nobody wants to wear a bikini and not feel comfortable in it. And I totally get that. But don't think about it as, I just want to get fit for the summer. If you want to make a change, then it has to come like from internally. It has to be a lifestyle. It can't be something that you want to do for a week or two, or you think, well, I'll just diet throughout this whole week and I'm gonna lose all this weight and I'll keep it off. And that's not how it works. So your mentality approach has to be, this is a lifestyle, this is what I want, and you have to really stay focused and stay committed. This is a process. It takes time. It doesn't mean that, you know, you're not gonna drop 10 pounds instantly. And if you do, then that's probably because you did a dramatic change in what you were intaking. I'm talking about food and like drinks and stuff. And so obviously you lost all that weight, but as soon as you start eating like that again or doing the same habit, you're gonna pick up the weight like right away again. So it has to be a lifestyle. It has to be something that's gonna be consistent. You have to be consistent. Consistency is key when it comes to food, when it comes to being active. If you're not consistent, you will not see results. The next thing is, so tip number two, trade water for anything that you drink. Honestly, this is where I started seeing results right away. So in my freshman year, I gained about 25 pounds, and I had horrible eating habits and drinking habits. And so as soon as I stopped drinking alcohol, as soon as I stopped drinking pop, and as soon as I stopped drinking juice, honestly, I saw major results. I dropped about 15 pounds immediately, and that was because drinks, alcohol, one, has a whole bunch of empty calories, which is just going to turn into fat. Second, juice has so much sugar, and water should be your best friend. Drink water at every meal. Maybe drink water 30 minutes before your meal. It'll help you feel fuller. Drink water when you wake up. Drink water before bed. That's what makes most people gain a lot of weight, is because they constantly have a lot of sweets. It stores in as fat, so it should be used as glycogen, but that's only when you're being really active and, you know, when your heart is at an elevated rate, then that's going to use it right away as energy. But if it's not going to be used as energy, it's going to be stored as fat. And so that's what you don't want, because that's what's going to cause you to gain the weight. So try and cut down on sweets. I'm not saying that you can't have sweets ever, but I am saying try and cut down on macros. Is basically fats, your carbs, and your protein. So basically, everybody is consuming some kind of macro. You're either consuming a lot of protein or a lot of carbs or a lot of fats. For everyone, it's going to be different, especially for beginners. You really are going to want to know where your body is at and how much you should be consuming. Tip number 6 is don't be afraid of the weights. When I first started, all I did was cardio. I went to the gym and did cardio maybe for about an hour or an hour and a half every day. And I probably started hitting the weights within a couple months after I was just doing a whole bunch of cardio. But the weights is an amazing way to also lose fat. A lot of people think that you're gonna build all this muscle, but honestly, it's not as easy to build muscle as you think. I've been wanting to build a lot of muscle, specifically like on my glutes or on my legs or in my biceps. So it does amazing things. It helps you drop weight fast and it helps you start getting more tone and it keeps everything tight. On bodybuilding.com, and it's amazing because it tells you what the exercise is, it tells you the correct form to do the exercise, and it tells you, and it also even gives you videos on a person showing an example of how the workout is done. And so it's really good. I'd really recommend that for beginners, to use it as a guide on how to use the weights. I would use a journal. So this is my journal. Well, this is my new journal, but I can show you guys my previous journal. Well, especially like when you're first starting off, it's easy to just be like, I'm gonna get a gym membership and I'm gonna go every day and I'm gonna eat super healthy and I'm gonna drop all this weight, and you're super excited, so you just start. But then like the moment that you don't see results, or the moment that you're lazy, or the moment that you just want to sleep in instead of going to the gym, or the day when it's rainy out or it's cold out and all you want to do is just stay in and you just want to make hot chocolate and need a bunch of chocolate, you know, that day comes around and you no longer want to do it because it's hard. It's not easy going to the gym every day. It's not easy waking up early every day. It's not easy going to work every day and making time for the gym. Or it's not easy to go and shop for healthy foods when you can just go into like the frozen food section, or where you can just get takeout or drive through. No, this lifestyle is not easy. This lifestyle is also not for everyone. You know, so make small term goals and make long term goals. But just make sure that you're actually setting goals. And remember that beauty comes in all shapes and sizes. Just because you're not a size 0 or a size 3 doesn't mean that you're not beautiful. About a year ago, I did not love myself. I didn't like the way that I looked. I didn't like the way that I felt about myself. I was super active and like going to the gym 6 times a week, and I just didn't feel confident in my body, and I really didn't like who I was. You know, I felt like, I don't know, I just was never myself around people, and I just felt shy and I didn't want to talk to anybody, and I just wanted to be left alone because I just didn't love who I was. And I felt like because I didn't love who I was, then I felt like other people weren't gonna love me or like me, because I saw myself as something unworthy and I saw myself as someone unlovable. So I felt like others couldn't love me or couldn't like me, you know, if I couldn't even like myself. So I don't know when it happened, and I don't think that there's like a certain point in time when you just wake up and say like, oh, today I'm gonna love myself. Like, no, I don't think that's how it works, because I tried that a lot and it never really worked for me. I mean, maybe it worked for like that day, but it wasn't consistent. So you need to love yourself before you can love another, because how can you give to others what you don't have? Still put you first and we'll make this thing work, but I think we should. I think it's important for every woman to love herself, because you want to be the best you. You want to be whole. You want to be filled, you know, and you don't want to try and find your happiness and try and find your love and your self-worth in other people, especially in relationships, you know. And it's like, when you love yourself, you just see yourself completely different, and you don't allow anything to stop you. I mean, your energy level when you love yourself is completely out of the roof. The vibe that you have with others, it's completely different, and people feel that and they notice that, and that's what you want to be all the time. This ain't a movie, no, no fairy tale conclusion, y'all. To have a foundation, whatever that foundation may be, your foundation should be grounded and rooted on something deep, something, it's like a spiritual connection within you. You and something else. For me, that's God, and it always has been. But for you, it might be different, but you have to know what your foundation is, because if you have a weak foundation, then whenever the storm comes and whenever the storm rises, your foundation is going to be quick to fall. And that's not what you want your life to be like. You want to be strongly rooted in your foundation to when bad days happen, when bad circumstances come around the corner, you're gonna persevere. 'Cause we're ordinary people. Maybe we should take it slow. That's the kind of person that you should want to be at all times. And it comes from a place where you love yourself, and a place from where you know who you are. And no matter what people say and do, you will always be just yourself, you know, because you fundamentally know who you are inside, and no person can change that. And who you are is beautiful, and who you are is more than enough. And because you are different and because you are unique, you have special things to offer, and no one else can be that. Only you. Maybe we'll grow with